Alright, so before the video starts, I just want to let you know that I do have a Patreon. So yeah, if you're interested in seeing my full on-cut reactions and the full length reactions, the link to my Patreon is in the description, and you'll also be able to see the reactions a few days or like a week early. So yeah, if you're interested in that, the link is in the description. But as for now, let's get straight into the reaction. Alright, so welcome back to another reaction on the channel. Today I'm going to be starting a completely brand new series by the name of The Expanse. I have heard of it before, well I didn't until recently, but I've heard that it's really good. It's a really good sci-fi show set in space. So yeah, I thought why not give it a try. I really love sci-fi shows, and I've actually been meaning to find some more time travel sci-fi type shows. I'm pretty sure The Expanse doesn't have time travel, but I know it's a heavily sci-fi show, and that is set in space, but that's pretty much all I know about the show going into it. There's literally nothing for me to add, because I don't know anything about the show, although it does have 6 seasons, and I think the last season came out really recently, like in 2021 or early 2022 or something. But yeah, I don't really know anything else. I want to get straight into this episode. So yeah, this is going to be a really short intro, but yeah, this is going to be The Expanse, Season 1, Episode 1, and yeah, let's get straight into this. Alright, this episode is called Dulcinea. Wait, so is this set on Mars as well? Like, do they go to different planets and shit? Oh, it's actually based on novels, right, yeah. Holy shit. Damn, this is much cooler than I thought it'd be. I had no clue what this story is about, but I'm intrigued now. Oh, is this like a prison in like Mars or... God, that'd be so weird having prisons in space. But I guess of course there would be if they colonized it. But no, it says Mars is a separate military power. And that they're close to going to war, so is this on Mars or? Yeah, I was gonna say I don't think you're getting out of there, but I guess you are. I mean, it said there just needs to be one spark, so is she going to be the spark to cause the war, or...? What was that? Was that a guy?
But in their eyes, we are not even human anymore. So the next time
this show seems like a very high budget. Alright, so all of this is under control by the UN, the United Nations, and they've colonized space pretty much, right? But Mars is a separate military... This is looking like a really cool sci-fi show though. I love the premise of this so far. I think I need to watch this a bit more before I even start trying to guess what's going on, and
promise you things will not go well for you if you do not.
Oh, you hit her.
Hey, take the cops off. If I want his ass kicked, I'll do it myself.
I know who you are. I'll find you.
God, this is so weird. It's so futuristic.
Black sheep.
Oh, that's the girl we saw at the start, Juliet, who was in prison, she literally broke free or whatever. We saw her, like, drilling a door open,
what's my contract
and looking
exactly?
At this, like, power, fusing core or whatever. It's reminding me of Fallout 4 for some reason, like, the my Institute, I don't know why, but... Oh, that is weird, oh my god. The way they put that in perspective then.
Watch out!
Oh, is that his arm? What the fuck? Alright, now that is crazy. I'm sorry, but that is insane. Yeah, I guess that would open up a lot of opportunities. No gravity.
Biogel they developed on the inner planets. And you wouldn't need a prosthetic. It regrows the limb perfectly.
Screw the inners in their magic general.
That's awesome.
No offense, Holden.
No, I mean, yeah, it's the future, so they have all these methods now, don't they? All this gel to regrow your arm and prosthetics. You can even imagine how high-tech everything would be.
I do have.
Okay, so this is at Saturn, right? Well, not Saturn, it's that... We just saw it a minute ago, I forgot the name of it, but that's where guy lost his arm. This must be like the whole base of it.
My biggest failure in life.
So all I know is that this is near Saturn. Saturn. Looks like someone's gone batshit crazy. Maybe he just misses Earth. I mean, he's drawing like trees and shit, so. Wait, what? Is that who I think it is? Is that? Yeah, it is. It's Mike. What the hell? Mike Emmentrout. Obviously not, but from Breaking Bad and Beck or so. Jonathan Banks. Oh my god, I didn't know he's in it. That is sick.
Why couldn't we have brought more?
Mike has gone batshit crazy. I just can't believe he's in it, Jonathan Banks. I wonder if he have like a big character in this or not.
I thought I was getting my walking papers.
But yeah, as I said, I don't have a clue what this plot is, but so far this episode has been highly entertaining. Calls herself the
Scotland Line. Goes around, comes around. One of these days it's going to be us stranded out there.
Is that foreshadowing? I feel like that's foreshadowing. I swear that's at like 20,000 kilometers an hour. That's insane. But no, it's a detective that was going after Julie, wasn't it? And he was on, I don't even know where he's on, but these people are on a spaceship next to Saturn. And previously we saw Series 1, was it? It was somewhere in, I think it's by the moon. Yeah, and you just turn your back on them. Or her, whoever. Earth and Luna, okay. So are we on Earth? Oh damn, New York, alright, let's see this. This is gonna be interesting as hell. It always ends badly. God damn, look at them skyscrapers. I love this, it's so like futuristic and crazy, it's awesome, man.
Give him another 10 hours. If his arrives, call me.
What are they doing to him? Right, so we're back with the detective and Julie. That is trippy. The way the stars are moving on. Okay. Yeah, I feel like this is a show I really like. It's like one of them high budget shows. Like, I tried to get into Wheel of Time and it was like very high budget again, but that's just not my type of show. Like, this type of show is my type of show. And so far, it looks awesome. What are they gonna find? Yeah, nah, this isn't gonna end well, is it? They're not gonna find what they're looking for. They're gonna find something much worse, I feel like. Ain't gonna be good.
Engineering first. I wanna know why that reactor's offline.
Oh, the reactor is Julie. It's Julie, isn't it? She was in the prison and she went to the reactor and she did something to make this whole ship go off. Yeah, so it links us to that story with the detective and Julie. Exact same reactor.
Boarding you an A1 tight beam from the Canterbury.
Alden, ship just appeared near your location.
How is that possible? You cleared us out to a million clicks.
Yeah, what is happening?
Rendezvous point. Get the hell back here.
So yeah, growing up on these planets, well, in space, it obviously has an effect on your bones and shit. So that's why we saw earlier that their whole spine was like disfigured and like they was weakened or something.
We had an understanding, detective, an arrangement. You can't just—it was a mistake.
All right, so it's him that actually ruined the air filters. Oh shit.
6,000 click. 3.
Wait, what?
These were meant for us.
Oh shit. Oh shit.
Do it now.
Range 2-4 closing.
Stand by cargo door.
Captain, eject the ice shield.
We're on it. Stay off this channel.
Something you should know. What the fuck? How's that even possible? This is completely destroyed the entire ship. That ship was massive as well. Why did they do that? Why did the Mars people do that? Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of debris, isn't there? So yeah, that was my reaction to The Expanse Season 1, Episode 1. A really phenomenal episode. I actually really did enjoy that. Like, all throughout the episode, it was just so entertaining. I really did like the plot and the premise so far. Like, it's just really interesting. And yeah, the final with the mothership pretty much being completely nuked and completely destroyed. What's that all about? The Mars people pretty much set up a bait so they'd go and investigate. And yeah, they've used that to pretty much destroy their entire ship. All that's left now is the tiny ship, like the it's like a little pod or something that they use to actually get to the distress call pretty much. And so yeah, that's, they're literally all alone now. That's all they got, I'm pretty sure. And they went out so far, so they're literally so far out and they've got nothing now. They've only got themselves, and I don't even think there's food or water or anything on that like little pod. So I don't know how they're going to be surviving that. Yeah, we also, at the start of the episode, we also saw a new character, Julie. And obviously, she was a girl and she was in prison. And she managed to get out. And yeah, we saw her go to, like, the fusion core. So, like, the core to the actual ship. And it's presumed that that she actually wrecked it and pretty much destroyed the ship. And it was the same ship that they've gone to investigate. So it's kind of linking in both storylines. And obviously now that detective is looking for her and trying to figure out what the hell happened to her. Because apparently she's like the richest, or she's like the daughter of the richest man, or like the richest family or something. I wasn't quite sure, but she's really rich. And like, but yeah, it's safe to say that she has a lot of money and her family are very wealthy. Trying to think what else. I mean, obviously we learn about the United Nations and how they've got control of Earth, Mars, and they don't have Mars. They have Earth and Sirius, I think it was, or like Luna. They have all these different things, and Mars is actually a military, it's like a military superpower, like a power that is just military, has nothing to do with the UN, and they're close to going to war. And I think well, at the start of the episode, it said that all it takes is one spark to create the war. And I think that this now, them exploding that ship and killing all them people and nuking them, that's going to be the spark, and that's going to cause the war. So yeah, next episode, I think we're going to see the aftermath of that, and we're going to see the two powers going to war, the United Nations and the Mars. And yeah, we also saw on Earth, Earth looks completely different. We saw in New York, they've got massive skyscrapers, all this futuristic technology. It's really cool. I really love this sci-fi show. I really do love sci-fi shows like this, when they adventure into the technology of the future. And yeah, you see all these like futuristic and like crazy technology. It's just really cool to see, and I really do. And yeah, I really love the show for that element. And yeah, it's just amazing, because I went into this not knowing anything about the plot or the story. And so far, I've absolutely loved this episode, and I can't wait to watch more, really. So yeah, that was my reaction to The Expanse Season 1, Episode 1. A really great first episode. I'll definitely be watching more soon. And yeah, I really hope you enjoyed my reaction. And yeah, as always, cheers for watching.